You had to like. I don't even know what you did.
No, I have some Sharpies and water.
So is there,
I think Staples.
Let's see.
Or Office Depot.
Wait until you see Taylor's like outfit. Taylor's hat is made.
Yeah, the
king of fabulous right here. I love it.
I do love that hat.
Thank you. I had to fit more of the Texas style theme, y'all.
With the feathered cowboy hat.
Yeah. Well, I was kind of going for a Margot Robbie Barbie kind of style.
Oh!
And that didn't really
play. Hi, Barbie.
Hi, Barbie.
Hi, Barbie.
Hi, Barbie.
Hi, Barbie.
Hi,
Barbie.
Hi, Barbie. Hi, Ken.
Who's Ken?
Oh, this is gonna be epic. So soon.
Now I'm scared.
Yay, new victim!
I'm scared.
I thought you were saying it.
Hey Elgin, maybe this time I won't end up in the wall.
Oh, that works. Oh, that works. Hey, can I get one too?
Okay, 1, 2, 3, and raise red card's blood pressure.
10, 9, 8, 1, 2, 4.
Yeah, remix. I feel like 12 is probably in there somewhere.
We still got a minute or two of start, so
21.
Guess what, everyone?
What?
Taylor made a terrible mistake inviting me to.
Hey.
For my services, where I am so very important. You must read a pun.
Oh!
Hey, you should have Vivid read one too.
Oh god. I love his face right now.
Alright, here's a good one for all of you. I was arrested yesterday after the neighbors complained about me playing Engelbert Humperdinck records all night. Police released me. Let me go.
There it is.
Before the panel even started? Wow.
Yeah, it's a new record.
That's an accounting record.
Joe is already against the wall.
And it's only day one.
Anyone else have the guts?
Oh, of course.
Brave soul.
I'm going to be a daddy.
Squared.
Oh. 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 Yeah.
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 ZTV exclusive.
Yes.
Hey, that one's actually
ZTV.
Pretty good.
Okay. All right. I'll do this in my newscaster voice.
Oh yeah.
Okay.
Oh, here we go.
My wife stormed into the pub last night as me and the boys were drowning shots of tequila. "You're coming home right now," she shouted. I laughed and said, "No, I'm not." "Not you," she said. "I'm talking to the kids."
Oh!
Have you ever eaten a clock? It's very time consuming.
It's so good that I went back for seconds.
Hey, I've got a riddle.
Oh, God.
There's a man that was in the desert for 3 weeks and he survived. All he had with him was a calendar. How did he survive?
Yeah,
she got in
my own review.
He crossed off 4 days and he was.
He ate the Sundays.
Oh!
Good afternoon, Harmony Call!
Woo!
Welcome in. So,
Harmony
Call, we get ready to match the stars.
Woo!
I'm actually scared this panel got accepted yet again.
Woo!
Okay, so I'm going to ask a general question here. Who has been to My Little Match game before?
Woo!
I'm so sorry.
Aww.
Alrighty, so we have some pretty all-star celebrities up here. We have Red Card up here.
Woo!
So, my ever-loving Clarence on this panel here. On a scale of 1 to 10, how fried is your brain after doing 3 match game panels?
More than a 10.
Yes.
Yes. that's my answer, I'm sticking to it.
We also have the wonderful Bobby Sees up here, who happens to also host My Little Millionaire and also Trivia Drop tonight.
Yes! He's going to be a contestant.
Exactly. So, from one game show host to another, how does it feel to be on the other side of the table for a game show?
It feels weird that I don't know all the answers ahead of time.
That's usually my answer whenever I go to Olive Garden, and I can't figure out what's on the menu these days. Of course, we have Vivid Syntax up here.
Woo!
Vivid, who did a masterful job for Ponyville Cyberfest's theme this year.
Woo!
So Vivid, would you do that again if you could? That's a very appropriate answer. And we also have the wonderful Joey O here.
Yeah!
So Joey, just for reference, the audience can't see, but can you see ponies in real life?
Yes!
So,
are they here now?
Who can you see in this room right now?
Who's with us?
Who is?
Luna.
I see a Luna.
I see a lot.
Whenever Septuagint Harmony gets up in the morning, how do you all decide who cosplays who?
We fight in a death battle.
I think they're going to be shrunk a little.
Yeah, exactly. That's why you don't see us that often after our clothes anymore. Oh my god.
Alright, so the way this game is going to work is that I need 2 contestants to come play match game.
Hmm.
That's a lot of hands.
Get out of the back.
Stay great.
Oh, the princess duo.
Alright, so let's welcome in our first two contestants for My Little Match Game. We'll start with you on the left here.
Princess Luna.
Princess Kate.
Introduce yourself.
Hi, I'm Sacred.
I'm Sacred.
You are very sacred.
Thank you.
Bless you.
Hi, I'm Nameless, member of Crackle's cousin for cosplay.
Oh, yay!
No, not actually nameless. Like, just my badge only says Crackle's cousin. Oh. No, for those who don't know me, I'm
Tara. So, does that mean your cosplay group is like the board? You're just like one of five? Three of 20?
I don't know. I was told I couldn't have my own identity this weekend, and that we were all clones of each other. So I'm like, all right, cool. So I'm Crackles, you're Crackle, everyone's Crackles.
We're all Crackles.
We are Crackles. We are Crackles. Right, so, you already cosplayed Resistance as Futile.
All right, so the way this game is going to work is that the two of you will get two different prompts to try to match as many horse celebrities up here as best you can.
Oh, God.
The person with the most matches.
I wouldn't say celebrities.
Oh, yeah. You're all celebrities. I'm not the celebrity up here. I'm the boring host up here. Suffers.
You're the one with 100 starlight glimmers all over your body.
Have we ever counted?
I've got to ask, do you have a tattoo of starlight?
I wish.
Oh!
I will
challenge accepted.
Go to Batscon. They'll do
tattoos
on Batscon.
I think we're required to be a Batscon, or else they're going to send a search party out there to look for me.
It's going to be hard not to find me.
Thank you, Bobby, for that. So. The way we're going to decide who goes first is I'm going to think of a number between 1 and 100, and the person with the closest number to the number I'm thinking of will go first. So, Sacred, 1 to 100.
17.
17?
I was
going to
go with
13
since I'm wearing a Taylor
sweatshirt,
so.
I was thinking 11, so.
Oh, wow. Ooh, yeah.
Taylor for the win. So. Shake it off. It's okay.
Okay. I think one of our contestants is turning into an insult. Yeah.
That's Taylor Tara's version. Oh my gosh.
I hope there's no bad blood between you two.
I don't see any blood at all. I hope I don't.
Oh, I'm asking for that vigilante shit. It's okay.
But is there bad blood?
Mm. All right, so Tara, would you like question A or would you like question B?
Question B.
Let it be.
As in Brayburn, Finn's favorite pony. All right. Players, get ready?
Yeah.
Stop looking.
Queen Haven said, I saw the strangest thing on TV yesterday. The ABC Alicorn blanked the ZBS eye.
What?
I'll say that again.
Yeah, please.
Queen Haven said, I saw the strangest thing on TV yesterday. The ABC Alicorn blanked the ZBS eye.
Oh, I'm glad the ZBS advertisers aren't watching this.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. How's everybody's army gone so far?
Woo! Is this the PG-13 version?
It's the PG version.
Thank God.
Okay.
Does it not look like a
great many people rewriting their
answers. Okay. Queen Maven said, I saw the strangest thing on TV yesterday. The ABC Alicorn wiped the CBS eye.
CBS eye.
It's the logo.
Yeah.
It's
Zephyr Heights.
Yeah.
Lit. All right. Hey, no, that's not a bad answer. Until everybody goes, if that doesn't match, then okay, maybe it was a little good answer. So, let's start with you.
All right. I said befriended.
Befriended. That's kind of a wholesome. That's a wholesome answer right there. Liza, what'd you say?
I just heard a string of letters, so I just put the ABC 1 2 3.
H-I-J-K-L-M-N-O-P.
Vivis was thinking more of the Jackson 5.
Jackson 5, yeah, that's what I was thinking.
Tori.
Flashed.
Flashed. Okay.
With a camera.
Yeah, of course.
PG.
Yes.
Joey.
Flashed.
Flashed. Okay. Bobby.
I hate myself so much. Made passionate love to? I don't know.
Okay.
Okay.
Did you not understand the assignment?
I'd like to thank you all for coming to my last appearance on Match Game. This is why I should be a host. You should not put me back here.
Okay, hold them.
So Bobby didn't understand the assignment.
Just say I didn't write anything.
It's okay, Bobby. I didn't know the stick of saying this for one of the Starlight Quiver questions in Jeopardy today, so we're even.
This is
Red Bar.
This is already.
I know your answer is Queen or the Clorox over there.
So because they're two competing networks, I put Punched.
Red Bar, your answer was supposed to be Queen. Why are you choosing violence over here?
Yeah.
Go
me. I got scared. I heard lots of letters and I got scared, so I drew Fluttershy because I draw Fluttershy when I'm scared. Is this something I'm too British to understand?
No.
And
then
Fluttershy
that
is That
was
a very hard
one.
The best of answers, of course.
Yeah.
Arson!
Arson!
Alright,
so,
that was
you didn't match it anyway, but that's okay, this is only round one.
That,
you're
that
so sacred. Alright, so sacred, your prompt will go like this. Alright, everybody, we're going to reset here.
Yep, that was just a practice round.
Yep. Okay. Now you know how to
get answers into the crowd.
Alright. Y'all ready?
Yes.
It was New Year's, and Pinkie Pie ran out of paper for confetti. Isn't that shocking?
Oh, boy.
So she shredded her plank and threw the pieces out the window. It was New Year's, and Pinkie Pie ran out of paper for confetti. So she shredded her blank and threw the pieces out the window.
Oh no.
What a predicament for Pinkie Pie to not have confetti. It's like world cutting or something.
But wasn't there one scene where she just sneezed confetti?
But it was at the on the mark of the spot here.
She was having a supply chain problem.
Pinkie Pie ran out of paper for confetti. So she shredded her blank and threw the pieces out the window.
That was like cupcake wrappers.
Cupcake wrappers. Okay. I was expecting worse, but we'll go with that.
You weren't expecting an answer that made sense.
Could be anything. All right, so Silver, we're looking for cupcake wrappers.
Well, you're gonna have to look elsewhere. I chose the gift of the Magi route, and she shredded her mane.
That sounds like Pinkie Pie kind of on a budget kind of style right there, where she's just desperate at that point.
Oh, no, she did it for sheer delight.
I understood that.
Don't chuck stuff at the audience.
She shredded her recipe for cupcakes.
Recipe for cupcakes.
She has to destroy everything.
She doesn't memorize.
Tori.
Yeah, I actually said her cookbook. Oh, so we were matching.
Simpatico.
Joey.
I had a brain fart, so I thought she shredded gummy.
Oh!
Oh! Oh! I'm from Florida. I got alligators everywhere, so I thought it was gonna
be Joey, do you want to hug yourself?
Joey,
do
you
need
like an emotional?
I said she shredded her life savings.
Savings on My Little Millionaire.
Nice little plugging right there. Red card.
So, I mean, she ran out of paper, right?
Yeah.
But you didn't say she ran out of toilet paper.
Really?
Really, Red card? It's clean toilet paper. It's still in the roll.
Is it Charmin?
What brand is it?
Yes.
Yeah. Ultra soft or ultra strong?
Yes.
You know, I never realized Red Card was in the toilet humor, so I guess he just rolled with this. Gummy.
I said cupcakes with a little smiley face.
Oh, yes. You know what? I'll give you the point for that one. Yay! One point on the board.
Yeah.
Beppy.
Her friends. Oh!
As a compensation, my celebrities are going to get therapy after this. So, Sacred, you got one match out of that, out of whatever all that was. So, we're going to move into round two. Sacred, you're up by one, so you will go first in this first in the second round. Would you like question A or would you like question B?
Question B.
Question B. Alright.
We have a real pitcher's duel going on here.
Alright, so this is a short one, so get ready. Sunny, Izzy, Pip, and Zip all took a blank together.
Got an answer?
Yes.
What?
Shower.
Sunny, Izzy, Pip, and Zip all took a what together?
A run.
A run.
Okay.
That's just one, but I'm wanting to hear what everyone else just said.
Oh, yeah. Great.
It's supposed to be PG.
All right, Pigeon, what you get?
Silver.
A.
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 They took a name together.
Where do you think Sparky came from?
I actually agree. I said an A.
Joey, I think you're being a little low on this panel here. Joey.
Dang, don't even skip me.
All right, I thought it out, and I put egg.
What?
What?
Egg.
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 Egg. Egg.
Egg.
Egg.
Egg.
Egg. Egg. Egg. Egg. Egg.
Okay, so I did have a bit of trouble with this one.
Tori, did I skip you?
Yeah.
Tori. Sorry, I'm a little discombobulated. Wow. Everything
I'm down by a notch. You better watch it.
That? Egg.
Okay, so
Bobby.
Yeah, okay, so like I said, I was having a bit of trouble with this one. Obviously my mind was going one place and this is PG, so I just went with egg.
I don't get it.
So far this is like going exactly as I was planning. Red card.
So, this wasn't easy for me, and I had to really think really hard.
You're playing the chaos!
I put egg.
What is it, peer pressure?
They cheated.
I don't think anybody went for a run.
Lower your expectations.
Hey, listen,
your brain's
a little scrambled,
alright?
That's sappy.
You know, this is really hard.
This is like a crazy.
Had a broken horn. But after visiting the doctor, he told her, "Did you know your leg is broken too?"
No!
Family Channel!
Oh, no. And no
egg. Oh, God, no. No more eggs.
Tempa showed that she only had a broken horn. But after visiting the doctor, he told her, "Did you know your leg is broken too?" Tempa Shadow thought she only had a broken horn, but after visiting the doctor, he told her, "Did you know your blank is broken too?" What was broken?
All I can think of, because it rhymes with blank is blank, so we're just going to say blank.
Blank is broken. Blank is
fair answer. That's a fair answer.
Yeah. Well, that's why you don't know her cutie mark. Exactly.
We never see her cutie mark.
That's a good point. Silver.
I said funny bone.
Funny bone.
You would say
that.
Silver, that's a good one.
I said sense of passion.
Was Rarity the doctor?
Golly, your fashion is just absolutely horrid.
Stop it!
Sorry.
Oh,
that her heart is broken.
Aww. Aww.
All right.
I should have done that. Yeah.
That's a good one.
Oh.
Oh. Taylor.
No.
Taylor, are you crying?
No. I'm suffering up here. Joey.
I'll make you feel better or worse. I got confused again, and I don't know why I was thinking about this, but I just did it earlier, and I'm like, the IRS is broken?
What?
That her taxes are going to get messed up.
Well, I think Joey does have a bit of a point that the IRS is kind of broken sometimes, you know?
Yeah. Right. Why do we have to do the math? They have all the documents.
If you all get my doors, I'm sorry.
All right.
Okay, well, we actually do have a match among the panelists because I also said heart.
Aww.
See, the goal here is to match with the contestants, not with the panelists. If it's the other way around...
Well, if she had said heart, she would have 2 points and would have won the game.
Okay, to be fair, you two get brownie points.
Yay!
They don't count for anything.
I'm
going
to
put
my own stuff.
Oh boy, red card.
Red card.
So you can, Taylor, you can probably convince her right with this. And I put sanity.
Hey, that's a valid answer, sanity. My sanity's gone anyway.
You said
so.
Santa.
You broke Santa.
Wait, man, who broke Santa again?
Bro broke Santa.
You broke Santa?
Santa.
Santa.
Broke Santa.
Gobi.
I said relationships.
I like how they keep holding up egg. Like,
just give me this always
egg.
It's the only thing I can think of, but.
Sundance!
It wasn't
8 points. All right, so with that, we have a tie! Case of a scenario like this, so we're going to move into a tiebreaker round, and again, the person in this round with the most matches goes on the play, it's the head-to-head match, so I'm now thinking of a number again between 1 and 100.
17.
We know what's on your mind.
Say it. Go ahead, say it.
No!
Well,
why did I get the feeling that with that kind of reaction before you actually gave the answer, they were going to be 69?
I thought she was going to say 13.
I didn't want to say Taylor. What was the answer?
What's the number I was thinking of was 69.
Hey, wait a minute.
Isn't there
some kind of prize if you hit it on the nose?
Alright, so Tara, you will then go first again in this round. So would you like question A or would you like question B?
I didn't like B last time, so
let's try A. Okay, let's try A on this one. A for an atrocity. Okay, so the prompt goes. And this actually came from a fan submitted prompt. This came from Nora Mermaid, actually. Alright, so, Sweetie Belle lost her squeak. So when her voice gets super high, she blanks. So, Sweetie Belle lost her squeak. So when her voice gets super high, she does what?
She sings.
She turns into vegetables.
Alright.
She does have a music.
So we're looking for singing.
Well, you'll get more pyrotechnics out of me, she spontaneously threw my leg.
Her voice is really high and she swears.
Lots of apples.
You said number one.
I'm matching with the wrong people because I said she explodes. Oh.
She runs in the woods and then cries.
Aww.
And then she finishes.
Where are you going with this?
Yeah. Yeah. Not done yet.
And then she finishes her muffin.
Aww.
Now she.
Okay.
Every time.
Isn't that derpy?
Or okay. She doesn't.
Kind of, but yeah.
Okay.
It's
going to
be tough.
Wrong character.
That was given by them.
Bobby.
I think I know.
Go ahead, show it.
Oh my god.
Oh, I knew it!
What? I don't see hearts.
Hearts.
Come on.
Her butts explode.
Come back in here.
He is now in the back rooms.
There's actually a completely separate conference on the other side.
People in suits.
At least you're wearing a suit.
See, Bobby, at least you would blend in.
I know. I kid you not. I opened the door, and so there's like another little hallway. And then through the other open door, directly across from this one, there was just a bunch of people at a conference table, and they were all just looking at me.
Taylor, you should go over there.
That's true.
Not in this ghetto.
Trust me, I go out in public like this, I get arrested. Red card.
So, I'm not sure if this is like the proper word, but I just put mutes. Nothing comes out.
Mute.
She's mute.
That's a feature I wish I had for the podcast sometimes. Billy.
I was thinking about one of my favorite pastimes. When I get sad, you know, and something doesn't go the way I expect it to. And I thought that she finally experiences existential dread for the first time.
Yikes.
She realizes she grew up.
Yeah.
Puberty. Your power pack says 69.
Yeah.
I
hope
this spontaneously combusts.
Yeah. All right.
Why do
y'all
want Sweetie
Belle to burst
with a flame?
I just
like
bursting.
I mean,
they
weren't
her
Twilight
game.
Yo!
Yeah. Yeah.
All right, Sacred. So the goal's easy for you. You need one.
One
match.
One.
One.
Just one.
Count
you
up.
Got
one.
This.
And your prompt will go like this.
One is the longest one.
Featherbane said to the psychiatrist, "Doctor, I think I need help. You see, I have fallen in love with my blank."
No.
Featherbane said.
No.
I'll just
pick the wrong prompt.
Featherbane said to the psychiatrist, "Doctor, I think I need help. You see, I have fallen in love with my blank." Same sanity. Featherbane said to the psychiatrist, "Doctor, I think I need help. You see, I have fallen in love with my what?"
Oh. My
cousin?
Oh, no! Well, there goes the PG rating.
I'm looking for cousin.
Are you?
Why are you in love?
I said he fell in love with his shadow.
His shadow.
He fell in love with himself.
That's
with myself.
That's what I was going to say.
That's the one. Sorry.
It says he fell in love with his reflection.
His reflection. Joey.
I said plushie.
Joey, why? It
could be worse.
Hey, if it's a derpy plushie, it could be worse.
He fell in love with himself.
Yeah. You're matching.
Oh, wait, yeah, that's not
yeah. Yeah, they're all in that trace.
This is
all
the polar
opposite.
So I'm sort of following the narcissism here, theme here, so I said face.
Face. Gobby.
Given who he was based off of, I found something that was unlovable. So his music.
Oh. An interesting scenario. If Safi does not match this next one, I don't know what to do here.
Oh, God.
Safi.
Question your life choices.
I have bad news for you. I went with fish.
What?
Bad news, that's the best one.
Hey,
Joe, you can't
here.
I'm too thrilled to be on.
I knew something sounded fishy about that one.
It has been 45 minutes and we've only had one match.
We've had two.
Okay, two.
One each.
All right, so I've never had this scenario happen before.
Everyone's a winner.
Play again?
Yay!
Sudden death round where we both, like, submit and then we see who we can do it.
Okay, so.
Just one more prompt.
Just don't come up with the same answer.
So here's how this how tiebreaker round two is going to work. Is you will give one prompt and you two will give me two answers. The person that has the most matches will go on to play the head-to-head match.
Okay.
And if you give this prompt, if you somehow screw this prompt up, I'm done after this game.
Why'd you get another tie? Just watch.
All right.
We just gotta walk out.
Sudden death or two. Spike said, Twilight Sparkle treats me like a dog. For my birthday, she gave me a blanket.
Oh.
Oh.
Everyone's gonna say the same thing.
Spike said, Twilight Sparkle treats me like a dog. For my birthday, she gave me a blanket. So Spike said, Twilight Sparkle treats me like a dog. For my birthday, she gave me a what? Sacred.
We'll wait at the shelter.
We'll wait to the shelter.
Oh,
my God.
Super basic, a squeaky bone.
Yeah! Yeah! All right. Let's see. Let's see how this works. Because if we have to third tiebreaker, I don't know what I'm gonna do. Silver.
Sorry,
but
I
want to
see you have meltdowns. So I said neutering.
I think a squeaky bone is technically a chew toy.
Yeah.
Woo!
Yeah. I also said a chew toy.
Yay! Yeah.
Joey.
I said a real spiky wikey.
What?
What?
What
do you mean?
What does that mean?
That means he had a brain fart.
I went a little more specific than a chew toy. I went with a tennis ball.
All right.
Oh.
Red Bar.
I also said chew toy.
Yeah. Oh. Yeah.
I said woof
woof
bow wow. Honestly, I don't know what
he was saying. Sammy.
I said
collar
and leash.
Oh. Tara, you're in the match game. Done yet.
Oh,
okay. Now, finally, we get to play the head-to-head match.
Finally.
Yeah, finally.
Hey, it was quality entertainment.
Tara,
yes.
You have the choice to go head-to-head against one person on this panel. Who would you like to go head-to-head with? Because it would make this prom perfect.
Choose Richard!
I'm hearing two very different answers, but...
What did your heart say?
Run!
Yeah. My heart says that an indecisive person with ADHD shouldn't be made to, forced to make decisions like this.
Aww.
Same here, don't worry.
You want me to pick for you?
Yeah, you know what, Taylor can pick.
That's red fine. Car!
Okay. Yay!
I'm gonna love this prom with all my heart. Oh, all right. So, Red Car and Tara, your prompt goes like this.
Sorry, just
in case it didn't exist. Red Car. All right. You ready? Blank card. Blank card.
Blank card.
Yep.
Blank card.
Blank card.
Sneaking suspicion.
I'll just pick something completely random.
Alright. Tara. Blank card.
Blank card.
Flash card.
Possibilities are endlessly.
I know. They're
go hold them. That's usually what works.
I highly, highly doubt. At least I hope that people aren't just going to put red. So, because of that, everyone. Probably
just
do 8, but no.
Stick with your first intuition.
Yeah.
Don't second guess yourself.
Yeah. Go with the first thing that came to your mind.
No, I think he's gonna hold something random.
You know what? Forget red cards. How about some?
Race car?
Red car.
So I'm
looking for the other you.
What other me?
The one that's the sperm car in the countryside.
So I'm kind of reminded of what happened. What? I'm reminded of what everyone did during the jackpot panel at Everfree last year, when everyone just did something card, and they didn't think of Pokemon cards.
Oh! Pokemon card. Well, Tara, unfortunately, you did not match with Ripper, but
sorry, Tara.
You still won overall, and that's all that really now matters. So, thank you both so much for being here.
Yay!
Oh, and
let's
not forget, egg!
Hey!
So instead, they decided to feast on blank.
Oh. Hey!
I'll ask you after they're done answering. I want to hear the best possible match answer for this, so I'll repeat it one more time. It was Thanksgiving in Maritime Bay. However, every pony was angry at Izzy when she burned the turkey. So instead, they decided to feast on what?
Feast on a corpse.
Oh! I didn't know you was here!
Listen, ponies aren't supposed to eat meat, they're already eating turkey.
Sappy.
What?
Savvy.
Savvy. You're not savvy. That's savvy.
All right, savvy.
You're pretty savvy at this game, aren't you?
Bread.
Bread.
Bread. Bread. Chinese.
Chinese. What?
Me?
You?
No. My guess would be
Sparky.
Sparky.
That would be my inspiration.
Inspiration.
Or craft supplies.
Bread supplies.
Craft supplies.
Craft supplies. Fluffle-puff.
I was just gonna say, hey, my God!
Smoothies.
That's
the appropriate answer.
You in the back.
Sprout.
Go get it.
Welcome to the
Oh, all very good answers. All very good answers. But let's see what they said.
If they all said egg, I swear to God.
So, well, again, I'm not as dark as some of you. I just went with the tears.
I am.
It must have been 1929 back in Maritime Bay. Back then.
I am as dark as some of you. I said each other.
Corey.
Sparky.
Yeah.
You're not much better.
They fed on Sparky. Yay!
It's tough times, so the family.
Oh!
The
cannibal?
Yeah.
This is the
family
that
just cooked it, like,
slept
it off and everything. No. No, I don't want that.
Sparky.
Rickard. So I didn't go quite as dark. You remember the episode where they had to, where instead of turkey, like in Everybody Loves Raymond, they did fish instead? I put fish.
Yes.
But Featherbine's just
fell
in love with his fish.
Fish.
What? How could you?
Yaldi.
I said the flesh of the uninitiated.
And egg.
I said, Sparky!
Hey Taylor, can I do something in life at the most popular age for being Sparky?
What's that?
All right. Come on, Sparky.
Oh.
No, who went to Winnie City? That.
Man,
you
get that Sparky a lot.
Yeah. They have Sparky. Poor Silver Quill's knees were like dead after that.
Cue the music.
Okay, you know what? I'm gonna do one more prompt since we got. We're gonna crack this in two.
Oh no!
Oh God!
Crack this egg. What?
Because I'm just that good. All right. So this came from Spiky Dash.
Hey,
it's my dad. All right, so final prompt for Match Game. Zip's visor had a technology fail that was so bad that when
how
she was looking at
that,
it? What? I say, oh, thank you. So
how bad was it?
Got it?
What happened?
What?
What?
How bad was it?
Okay, let me say that again so I can hear it. Zip's visor had a technology fail that was so bad.
How bad was it?
First time someone's actually done that for this panel.
Yeah.
Now, when she was looking at Pip, instead of seeing her heart, instead it saw a blank.
Oh my god.
Cannot wait for these answers.
Instead of her heart, it saw
a blank. Decisions. So here's the problem. Here's the problem again. Zip's visor had a technology fail that was so bad.
How bad was it?
Thank you for humoring me. That when she was looking at Pip, instead of seeing her heart, it saw it blank. Best answers. Come on. Savvy.
A bone.
No,
a
bone.
A brain.
That doesn't
have one
of those.
All right. A donkey. Well, that's not very nice.
It's just a donkey.
Donkey.
There.
Donkey.
What was that?
Let
I heard what he said, but say it again.
What's your answer?
Say it again.
He's like, nope.
She has a better answer.
You in the back.
Cold, unfeeling YouTube algorithm.
No!
Sparky.
This is a question. Chris. He's not a thing.
A wig.
A wig.
A wig.
Go get it.
A Zephyr Heights credit card.
All right. Good answers. Silver.
Based on this game, I said a rift in Taylor's soul.
I like that.
Just cost one.
Pip's always on my grind, so I put a bottle of Pip's brand new fragrance Eau de Cologne available for only $19.99. Only for $19.
Hey, on pivots, remember, this princess smells.
So can you. So can you.
Joey. I said Elon Musk in a Cybertruck.
That's the best answer all night.
Bobby. I think the closest I can get is the YouTube algorithm guy. Family Guy Funny Moments number 37 extended.
Right,
so I took the Cole Donnerstag run, I put PMV.
Kobe.
I put Sparky. We still don't know how he got out of that.
That's why she's so chubby.
Oh.
I didn't know what to put, so I put A.
My little match here. Silver Girls, Vivid, Tori, Joey, Bobby, Red, Gobi, and Sappy for all being amazing. You've all been an amazing audience. Thank you all so much for coming out to My Little Match game. Enjoy the rest of your convention and have a great rest of your day. Thank you all so much for coming.
Hope you enjoyed our adventures at HarmonyCon. Stay tuned for more upcoming adventures. Bye, guys.